Because at least from the time of René Descartes and the Enlightenment, folks, got a little bugly list jarred all over. Now I feel like Father Marty. For centuries, the church laid a strong prohibition against cremation, principally because many of those who were opting for cremation were doing so as a way of mocking the Christian faith in the resurrection of the dead. That they said that, well, if I burn my body up, Jesus can't possibly bring me back to life. And that, of course, is absolute rubbish. God is God. He can do whatever he wants. But as a way of guarding the faithful against such a notion, the church just said no to the question of cremation. It's been a long time, I think, in most parts of the world since anyone has asked for cremation for that purpose, to mock or deny the resurrection of the dead. In many cases, it becomes a question of economics. It had been cheaper to cremate someone than to bury their full body. In other places, it has to do, like in New Orleans, a question of the water tables. Can we actually have a burial? Maybe even places like Alaska, where the snows, the cold, gets too cold in the ground in the wintertime to actually dig a grave. So all these other questions come in. So for the last 60 or 70 years, the church has said, we can tolerate cremation if someone is not doing it to mock or deny the resurrection of the dead. But even those cremated remains have to still be treated with the same dignity as the full body of a person. Because even those, the cremains, the ashes, if you will, they still are the remains of a temple of the Holy Spirit. So the cremated remains of a person still have to be either entombed in the ground, entombed in a mausoleum, placed inside a columbarium, something like that. They can't be kept in a family home. They can't be scattered to the winds or tossed into the sea, because the temple of the Holy Spirit deserves to be honored. And it may be that you know whose cremated remains remain above the mantel place, and your children might, but at some point all of that gets lost. It gets forgotten about. And at some point, God forbid, somebody's cremated remains may just be tossed aside. And because of the dignity that we have as sons and daughters of God, as temples of the Holy Spirit, the church never wants that to happen. So as a way of preserving the dignity, of safeguarding the dignity of each person, the church says if cremation is done, the cremated remains must be treated in the same way as a body and interred in a cemetery or in some other sacred place.